You in your right mind? You the only righteous people on the face of the earth. Your leaders refuse to go in this Bible to give you a solution. But right now, today, that time is up. There's no more giving you lies. We're not African. We're not black. We're not Jamaican. We're all from the 12 tribes of Israel.
So we're supposed to give a warning.
We're not judging you, we're warning you.
Well, have we seen any change?
Yeah.
Have we seen anything that has changed our people? Changed our neighborhood?
Who does God love? Who is all of us? Is it the whole world? Is it all the people? Who? You gotta explain. Okay. That's what we've been taught in the world, right? Now, who taught us that? Who taught us God love everybody, Lorenzo? Okay, the preachers. Okay. Now I'm gonna show you something. Hold that sign up, Jam. Hold that sign up. Give me Proverbs 3:31 real quick. Come closer, Lorenzo. Come closer. In slavery, 1619, this happened, right?
Yeah.
We talked about it in school. Now, you ever,
tell us everything.
Right, they tell us everything. You ever seen the movie Birth of a Nation? Nat Turner? Well, in that movie, Nat Turner, he was a slave that was bred to teach the slaves about Jesus, to preach to them. He was taught by the slave master. So the same people that taught our pastors that look just like me and you, the same people that was beating us in slavery. You understand? The same people that taught our pastors about God, right, was the same one that took us into slavery. So the question is, who taught us God? Because think about it, Lorenzo, because if it was the pastors, well, the pastors were taught by somebody. So who taught us about God, Lorenzo? The slave owners. Now, I'm going to show you something. Give me Joel 2:27 real quick. I'm going to show you something, Lorenzo. Watch this. Joel 2 and verse 27. Because that's what the world says. God loves everybody. But in slavery, what happened to us in slavery, Lorenzo?
Treated us bad.
Ah, come on. That's it? This bad? I want you to explain what happened to us.
We got whipped, tortured. They used to rape the woman. They used to make us, I don't know, a lot of stuff.
Yeah, a lot of stuff. Yeah. They used to make us have sex with our mothers.
Yeah.
Think about that. Now, the same people that did those things to us was praying to God. Would you agree? There's prayer to their God. Now I'm gonna ask you, the people that the atrocities was put on, who were they praying to? They was praying to the same God. So the question is, if God loved everybody like they say, how come slavery lasted for so long? And even to this day we still slaves. If God loved everybody, the slave master was praying for slave, the slaves was praying for freedom. If God loved everybody, how come we never got free? That's my question. Go ahead, Cap.
It's called From Babylon to Timbuktu. It's a history book written by our own people, right? This is going in what he's talking about, it being forced on us. This is way back before we got here. By the edict of King Manuel of Portugal in 1496, all Jews were to be put out of Portugal by October 1497. However, considering this matter, he decided to Christianize the Jews.
The Jews talking about us. We became Christianized. We don't.
He concluded that the only way the Jews be tolerated in his country was to force them into the Christian faith.
How was we forced into Christianity, Lorenzo? Slavery. We was forced, our names were changed, our nationality was changed. Everything, even the very image of who we are, was changed. So if we couldn't read or write, who taught us how to read the Bible? Who taught us about God? The same people that did this to us. Now I'm gonna show you something, Lorenzo. Pay attention, read.
Joel chapter 2, verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
God says he dwells in the midst of Israel. He dwells in the company of Israel. Who is Israel today, Lorenzo? Put the sign down, Jerham. Who is Israel today? Hold the sign up. Israel today, Lorenzo, is the so-called blacks, Haitians, Hispanics, Native Americans. We are Israel. And you particular is from the tribe of Judah. That's what the brother was going over with you earlier. You come from the tribe of Judah. So when you hear Israel, it's talking about you.
Right.
Lorenzo, read it again.
Joel chapter 2, verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel. And that I am the Lord your God.
Now let's see if God is the God of everybody. He says, I'm the God of Israel.
And none else.
And what?
And none else.
What's your wife's name, Lorenzo? Renika? Krenika? Hey, what's going on, brother? I remember you. All praise. Good to see you. Good to see you. All praises. Renika? Krenika. Now, I'm ask you. Is she the wife of everybody? Who's she the wife of? So if she say, if she telling me, God, I'm only the wife of Lorenzo, can I therefore look at Renika and say, but you're my wife too? Can I say that? Why not?
Because she's mine.
Huh?
She belongs to me.
Now I'm going to show you something. Give me Jeremiah chapter 3. You know what I want, right? Huh?
Lord, you said.
He did, huh? Say what? Watch this. I'm gonna say he's for you. Watch this.
Jeremiah.
Now the same analogy I just used about Granica, your wife. If she says I'm the wife of you, Lorenzo, I cannot therefore say, but Granica, why you're my wife too? Can I say that? Watch this.
Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 14. Turn, O backsliding children, saith the Lord. For I am married.
And what?
Married unto you.
Wait a minute. God says he's married unto the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
So can somebody else say, God, what about me? Can they say that? Why not? He's married to them. Just like you married to Granica. I'm not married to Granica. Only you can be married to Granica. God is married to the 12 tribes of Israel.
Yes, right.
We are the only people that can be married to God.
Right.
So that means no other nations gets in on this thing. No other nations. Hold on, Sanjay. If they're not on this sign, bro, no white man, no Chinese man, no Japanese man, no Arab man, they cannot be married to God.
Right.
God is only married to the 12 tribes of Israel.
Right.
That's it. What's up, Lorenzo? Go ahead.
I'm a little confused. This is a lot to take in.
Hey, but you know what? I'm telling you, the most I'll put on your spirit to come and learn the truth.
I appreciate that.
So let me ask you, Lorenzo, how you feel about God only being married to the 12 tribes of Israel?
I mean, it only could be filmed, but then at the same time, like, wow.
Watch this. I'm going to show you something. Get Amos 3 and 1. God says he's only married to the 12 tribes of Israel. Watch this.
Amos chapter 3, verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
Again, children of Israel, read.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, You only,
Lorenzo.
Have I known of all the families of the earth?
God says he only knows Israel.
Right.
Read.
Therefore, I will punish you. I will punish you
for all your iniquities.
God says, because I only know you, I'm going to put you in slavery.
Right.
Who else went into slavery on slave ships, Lorenzo? And who else? Because the Hispanics did too. And the Native Indians did too. So who else did it? Who else went through these atrocities? Who else? Did the white man? Did the Chinaman? Japanese, Arab, Russian? Give me some more.
Hawaiian?
The Hawaiian, the East Indian? They didn't go through this. Read the last part again.
Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquity.
You see that? God says, because I only know you, I'm going to punish you. Meaning what y'all go through, nobody else is going to go through. So the question is, does God love everybody?
I've been seeing you guys out here.
Oh, yeah?
And I used to wonder, you know, I have a couple of people I know, all they based on Israelites. Right. Not my first time hearing about the Israelites.
Uh-huh.
I heard about it before, but I never understood it. You know?
So when you
I
heard it,
there's so many different stories, so I pray to ask God, please send me to someone who actually believes in me.
Here we are. That's right. So now that you know, we gotta keep the Sabbath day. What else?
Go ahead. Get back on the
fasting.
Okay, fasting. What else?
You are not called black. You're called Jew.
You're called Jew. Jew. Judah. You are Judah.
Judah.
You are Judah. That's who you are. What else?
Yeah, but I've been thinking about that.
You shrimp, crab, lobster?
I'm not really.
Oysters?
I really don't do too much cooking.
I don't know what you cook. I said, what you eat?
Nah, honestly, I can't say I've been eating that so good. But I used to, yeah.
Pepperoni?
I like pepperoni.
Oh, hey, yeah, that's good. Hey, you're the spirit. Like pepperoni? Pepperoni's pork.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, Leviticus chapter 11, verse 7.
Bring it up.
And the swine.
The swine, which is what? Point.
Yeah. You know,
hold on.
Yeah, because he's the one who actually sent the evil spirit
to the pig. To the pig, right?
You know. Though he divide the hoof and be clothed footed.
Come on.
Yet he cheweth not the cud.
Read.
He is unclean.
He's what?
Unclean.
He is dirty, filthy, disgusting. Read.
To you.
Read.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch.
Then he eat. God says, don't eat them things. Can't eat pork. Pepperoni pizza out the window. You better get you some extra cheese like I do. Double up. Double up on the cheese. Yes, pepperoni, that's pork.
Oh, the thing? Oh, yeah,
yes.
Yeah. Okay.
That's pork.
Well, I mean, I don't care for
the
cheese.
Yeah, that's pork. Absolutely. I agree.
Numbers chapter 15 and verse 38. Speak unto the children of Israel.
But you are a Lorenzo from the tribe of Judah.
And bid them that they make them fringes.
Fringes? What a fringe. You ever heard of fringes? Fringes is what you see on a brother's bar. Fringes. You may say, damn, why everybody got on their shirt? It's a reason.
In the borders of their garments throughout their generations.
How long is the generation? Lineage. How long is the lineage? You still living, so your generation still gone. So God says you got to do this long forever.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders
on the top
a ribbon of blue.
Blue.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord.
God says you're supposed to remember the commandments. Look on it. Remember the commandments. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. You see big booty vessels walking down the street? You know it.
Quran. Damn, God says don't commit adultery, don't commit fornication. This thing's supposed to remind you who you are. And the stipulation that's going to cause you death, get death or get life. You know?
And do them!
And what?
And do them!
So, and when so? You need help, brother, we can help you. That's what you want, you can help you. That's not a problem. Prejudice ain't a problem, it's only the will. Do you have the will to do it? Because it's easy for us to help you, but are you willing to be helped? Are you willing to keep God's commandment? That's the question.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, that's one of them.
Don't praise you.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.